Good morning, everyone. And let us open up with a word of prayer. Heavenly Father, we come before you this morning in the name that is above all names. Your word says that this is a day that the Lord has made, and we shall rejoice and be glad in it. And what a day it is. Father, we thank you for enabling each and every graduate, Lord, to endure through the course of the Bible, the Joseph School of Business classes. We thank you, Lord, for enabling them to complete this race, and as they are yet to begin the next step in their journey for what you've called them to do, we thank you and we praise you for what you've done, for what you're doing, and for what you're yet about to do. And as we honor and recognize them for their achievements, Lord, we just thank you for making it all possible. And we are careful to give you all the praise, all the honor, and all the glory. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Praise the Lord. Well, at this time, I would like to invite to the stage the dean of our campus, Joseph Business School, Dean Dave Ramsure.
Drs. William and Veronica Winston, I would like to present to you at this time the Joseph Business School's 2021-22 graduating spring class.
At this time, I would like to call for the television ministry to roll the video clips. So if you will, please roll the clips.
Thus saith the Lord, thy Redeemer, the Holy One of Israel. I am the Lord thy God, which teacheth thee to profit, which leadeth thee by the way thou shouldest go. Isaiah chapter 48, verse 17. Although the Joseph Business School opened its doors in 1998, it was actually birthed 12 years earlier through a revelation that was given to Dr. Bill Winston by God after a time of prayer and fasting. God said, "Take the straps off," and led him to Isaiah 48, 17. To put it simply, God revealed that a business is any kingdom enterprise or company where Jesus is Lord, and that he was raising up godly men and women to manage these companies with great integrity using the principles of faith. As with all God-given revelation, it would powerfully change Dr. Winston and his ministry, and that revelation indeed would influence and change the lives of countless others, including global business leaders and heads of states and nations. Over the next three decades, this revelation became the seed that would birth an even bigger vision and mission to eradicate generational poverty in America and around the globe, and to create extreme wealth that would be used to transform desolate places into flourishing communities for the glory of God. As a result, the Joseph Business School launched 22 locations in five continents. As God reveals more of his magnificent plan, more entities and programs are being birthed to provide entrepreneurs, creators, and inventors an environment for innovative problem solving to bring lasting change to the world. But we are not yet finished. Our mission and vision became clearer: to empower entrepreneurs to produce indispensable skills and undeniable value, for our entrepreneurs to create income and employment opportunities for others through the wealth and job creation that entrepreneurship and vocational training can provide. This, in turn, will assist in the rebuilding of the inner cities, communities, and nations.
Some of you have had a spiritual
We are passionate about doing business God's way, and the best is yet to come.
Amen. Good morning, graduates. Good morning, Living Word family. Come on and stand to your feet as we enter into his presence this morning. How many know that the joy of the Lord is our strength? Come on, how many know that the joy of the Lord is our strength? Come on, clap it up. Hey, hey. Oh. Oh,
Praise the Lord. Amen. Now that's how you start a graduation ceremony, amen, with praise and worship. Well, greetings everyone. My name is Minister A.B. Ralph, and on behalf of Drs. William and Veronica Winston, the JBS faculty and Living Word Christian Center, I want to thank you all, those who are present here, as well as those who are viewing online. We welcome you all to the Joseph School Business Spring Class of 2022 graduation. Nothing perhaps gives us more joy than to see each of our graduates find and grow in their God-given purposes as they've now completed their 9-month training. And just as a baby is born after 9 months and steps into the world, they are now getting ready to step into their sphere of influence to be the movers and the shakers and leaders in the realm of business and economics. Praise God. They have now been equipped with the practical and biblical principles to raise up companies and create wealth, to transform desolate places into flourishing communities for the glory of God. Amen. We saw that in the video clips earlier that you just saw. We heard the prophetic word that came forward from Prophetess Cindy Jacobs. And let's give our praise team another round of applause. Amen. Well, without further ado, I would like to introduce to you the president of the Joseph School of Business, Dr. Dolores Thomas.
Good morning, everyone. Oh, thank you. That's so kind. Thank you. Thank you. You may be seated. They didn't give me a lot of time. First, I just want to say good morning to all of you, both you graduates as well as the families that have supported them in this journey. But most importantly, we give honor to God for bringing us through this season. Amen. Amen. You know, Dr. Bill Winston and his lovely wife, Dr. Veronica Winston, the amazing visionaries of this program, let's stand and give them a warm hand of applause. You know, it's amazing when God gives one a vision, but it's much, much more amazing when they say yes, because then we're able to see the harvest of the seeds that they've sown. Dr. Winston, several years ago, got a word from God, just a word. And the anointing that you're about to experience is what God can do with one word. And one word was in Isaiah 48, 17. And out of that obedience, you see many businesses, over 20 plus businesses, and he continues to create on an ongoing basis. That anointing is resting on you right now. Not only did he find somebody who was willing to sow a lot of seed, he also had him to partner with someone who knows how to pray. That anointing is resting on you right now. The power of prayer, the power of intercession, so that what God gives you can come to pass. When Dr. Winston asked my husband and I to start this program several years ago, I won't say how much because I'm much younger than that. I'm kidding. You know, he told us to go and start this this vision, and we actually told him that it was going to take 2 years. And he went and he prayed, and the Lord told him, go back and tell them 2 months. Now, this is the year of the miraculous, right? And the miracle happens when you know it's not your ability that makes it happen, but God's ability. And so out of obedience, we said, okay, if that's what the Lord says, then we'll do it. And look at what God has done. Not our ability. Look at what God has done. And so when he tells you to plant a $1 billion business, he's not asking you to do it. He's just asking you to obey him. And as you obey him, he will do it. Now, I gave honor to Dr. Winston, but there's another special person in my life that I must give honor to, and that's my husband, Pastor Ray Thomas. When I met him, he wasn't a pastor, he was an executive. And Dr. Winston, he's actually the one responsible for us even being here. Dr. Winston asked him to come and help to build out the sanctuary and build out the mall. And what I observed was the many nights that he would fast and pray, and he would just go before the Lord and cry to ask him, how should he bring this to pass? When I saw that level of commitment, an executive on his knees praying and doing the will of God, it just put me in awe, like, God, you are so good to give me a good man. So, Pastor Thomas, thank you. And I couldn't do all of this without an amazing team, and you'll get to meet several of them shortly, starting with Dean Dave, who's been with us from the very beginning. In fact, he was with Dr. Winston before he was ever with JBS. That program that he birthed before it ever became Joseph Business School, he was a part of that. So Dean Dave has just been an amazing person and leader. And you'll meet several other leaders, so I won't go through that. But what God started with a seed is now in 5 continents, 20 plus locations around the world. We just graduated a class in Lagos, Nigeria. We're in Europe. We're in Nicaragua. We're all over the world just from a seed. So that's what God is about to do. You know, when I was asking the Lord what to say, he reminded me of something. He says, if you have a house and someone comes in the house and says it's their house, would you be okay with that? Like, you're here right now. You're here right now. And someone got in your house and says, it's my house. Would you be okay with that? Well, guess what? God gave you a promise. And when you are okay with letting the devil tell you that that's not your promise, that's like allowing them to come in your house and to tell you it doesn't belong to you. So whenever someone questions whether or not what God has told you to do, just know that it's someone trying to rob you of your promise. It's the same thing. If you won't let them in your house, don't let them in your dream, right? And so God has promised that he will make you great. He will make you great. That's the promise. And make sure that you fulfill that promise. You know, Pastor Winston says that this is the year of the miraculous. And we like to sing, praise God, and do all the stuff to sound and look holy. But that wasn't a suggestion. That was a mandate. That was a command. And so when God is ready to do a miracle, the same faith you had to get in your car and come here today is the same faith you need to bring that miracle to pass. It is already done. It's simply us positioning ourselves to receive it. Like the lepers who say, why am I going to stand here? Let's go in at once. So I am decreeing on your life that you will not be in fear, you will not be in doubt, but you know it's already guaranteed that this year will be a year of the miraculous in your life. Amen? Well, without further ado, I know that you want to hear a lot about the Joseph Business School, and so I have my team that's going to be sharing that. And so first I'd like to bring up Dean Dave and Dr. Irene, and then you'll hear from the president of the Alumni Association, you'll hear from our director of our SBDC, just so that they could give you a little bit more, and I could share this wonderful stage, and you can hear more about the program. God bless you, and family, just know, when that praise and worship went forth, what that meant is that Jericho wall is coming down. Amen?
Thank you, Dr. Dolores. Appreciate that, those kind words, and it's good to be here today. Good morning, everybody.
Well, as Dr. Dolores mentioned, we want to share with you about our graduates and the programs that they've completed. And I want to talk to you today about the 9-month graduates. They have completed the entrepreneurship program that they took either online or through our virtual classroom environment. And in completing that program, they have learned the practical aspects of doing business God's way and how to apply biblical principles. Our graduates today started this journey back in April of last year. And we met weekly, and through the curriculum, the students learned all the fundamentals of business ownership, including learning how to decide if a business idea is a good one or not. And then once they decided on a business idea, or if they came to the school with already one business going, They learn next to know how to promote their business to customers and to the marketplace. And that made the marketplace aware how to do business with them. They also learned how to create and read financial statements. They learned how to select the proper legal structure for their business. You might have heard some laughing about those financial statements there. They also learned many other topics as well. And they pulled all this together to complete a comprehensive business plan for their personal vision for the business. And most importantly, when we went through all those practical aspects of business, they learned how to apply biblical principles such as the law of confession, prayer, faith, and many other biblical principles. And they took all that together and took action on their plans and their vision, and they achieved some supernatural results in the marketplace. And so we're excited to honor them today. And Dr. Irene will share about the Executive Accelerator Program.
Thank you, Dean Dave. The Executive Accelerator Program is uniquely designed for established entrepreneurs to develop strategies and execute actionable plans to scale their businesses. This six-week program helps students structure a cohesive learning solution to create value in their companies. Our primary goal was to match businesses with opportunities and resources to help them accelerate. Now, I would like to thank our staff and our faculty. Our special thanks to Drs. William and Veronica Winston for their vision, prayers, and guidance in taking the Joseph Business School to the top. They challenged us each day to think like God. To our leadership of the Joseph Business School, Dr. Dolores Thomas and Pastor Ray Thomas. A special thanks to Melissa Brown and her entire small business development team and the JBS staff. Thank you. To conduct such a unique school, we need a supernatural team. And we have that with our volunteer team. They are a great team of believers who are distinguished in their respective field of business. They serve the team as advisors, instructors, mentors, and evaluators. And some of these people are lawyers, CPAs, business execs, business owners who sow their time and talent to assist the students in following their vision. We cannot conduct the school without them. So we would like them to stand and we would like to thank them. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Irene. At this point, we'd like to bring up Dapo Kolawale. Dapo is a 2018 JBS graduate, and he is currently serving as the president of the JBS Alumni Association. Dapo, would you come forward, please?
Good morning. It's an honor to be in front of you this morning. Thank you, Dr. Winston, Dr. Veronica. Thank you, Dr. Thomas, Dean Dave. Thank you for this opportunity to talk to you this morning. I am honored to be with you and with you at your graduation from one of the finest entrepreneurial programs in the world. I want to say congratulations for successfully completing the 9-month JBS Entrepreneur Program as well as the Executive Accelerator Program. I've been through it. I know what it feels like to come through the other side, and I will say congratulations once again. Now I want to officially welcome you to the JBS Alumni Association. The JBS Alumni Association is a community of like-minded business people that is over 900 members strong, spanning 5 continents. Our mission to you is this: to empower you to achieve your God-given dreams and fulfill your destiny, to empower you to build global businesses that positively impacts your family, community, and the world, and empower you to dominate in every business arena. Through our events, community platforms, and monthly newsletters, this is how we want to make sure that you are continuing to build your dream after graduation. So be on the lookout for a welcome letter directly from me to you. We can't wait to celebrate you. We can't wait to shout you on the rooftop. We can't wait to see you on the cover of Forbes magazine, Inc. magazine. And in the name of Jesus, remember this. Nations will come to your light and kings to the brightness of your dawn. Let's go get it. Thank you. And now I'd like to invite to the stage the Director of Business Development and Corporate Initiatives, Melissa Duff Brown.
Thank you, everyone. It's such a pleasure to see you in real life. We've been doing everything virtual, so congratulations. One of the things I'd like to share with you and with the visitors is one of the important parts of the Joseph Business School program is the ecosystem that surrounds all of these graduates and all of these businesses. We support them with practical and real opportunity. So our team, in which we operate in three ways. We have a small business development center, and that provides all kinds of general business support. We provide market research. We provide access to e-commerce, access to government contracts with our Procurement Technical Assistance Center, and we have an international trade center where once your business model is perfected, we can help you to export your services and products to a mirror market anywhere in the world. But there's real opportunity. Our Procurement Technical Assistance Center opened in 2016, and since that time, we have helped over 600 businesses secure $1.2 billion in contracts. This is real opportunity. Our International Trade Center opened in 2018, and we are just about at $30 million in export sales. We partnered, Dr. Dolores partnered and saw why this support was needed. And since 2006, the Small Business Development Center has been operating as in connection with the Joseph Business School. And we have trained over 39,000 people and done over 18,000 hours of one-on-one counseling. Now, we can't do that by ourselves. There is a mighty, mighty team. Chris Hollinsworth is not here. He oversees our PTAC, and he is actually in Washington at a conference. He sits on the national board. But our other team members are here. Brian Butler, if you'd stand, he oversees our International Trade Center. Andy Pham oversees our Small Business Development Center. And then we have Brittany Wallace, who keeps us going and does so much for her. I know each and every one of you have worked with this team. We look forward to supporting you. Know that just because you graduate doesn't mean that the connection with us is over. And please stay in touch. We also have the Carver Innovation Center, which has supported some of you with your intellectual property needs as well as making prototypes. And check out training.josephcenter.com because you can continue to get your spiritual needs and your professional development needs done on demand. And so also there's other important parts of our organization, and I'm really excited to have the privilege to introduce the Assistant Dean of the Executive Accelerator Program and the Joseph Center Foundation, Jess Cotta.
Good morning, everybody. What a beautiful day to graduate today. Congratulations to our campus, online, and our executive program students, and everybody that's watching us around the world. We celebrate you today. My name is Jess Cotta, and I'm going to share a little bit about and introduce to you the Joseph Center Foundation. I also have a video where Dr. Winston shares his vision for some of the new exciting initiatives we're going to carry out through the Joseph Center Foundation this year. As a graduate of the Joseph Business School, God has given you that business venture to capture that wealth. Everything that you need to be become that million and billion dollar company, it's in you. And JBS has paved the way for you to produce that generational wealth. Today, you're in the army of God doing business while doing good in this world. And that's what the Joseph Center Foundation is all about. We partner with businesses just like yourself with a vision to transform the marketplace by bringing economic justice, wealth creation opportunities, and social entrepreneurship. God prepares the called, my friend, and you're called to be the financial gatekeepers of this world, to produce those goods and those services that is guaranteed to preserve all humanity, just like Joseph did in the Bible. Amen. To learn more or to partner with us, visit us at josephcenterfoundation.org. Let's watch this video.
Hello, Dr. Bill Winston here. I'd like to share with you a vision that God has given me called the Joseph Center Foundation. Now, years ago, God gave me the vision to start the Joseph Business School. Now, this is a school that trains entrepreneurs, but it trains them how to do business God's way. It's based on biblical principles. Now, this Joseph Center Foundation is what I'm starting to eradicate poverty by raising up entrepreneurs to provide jobs and training and resources for the underserved communities. Also, the Joseph Center Foundation will create an equity fund. Now, this is the fund that will have the financial resources that will help finance kingdom solutions. In other words, people who have businesses, they have a good idea, but they have no money to launch it. This equity fund will help to launch that idea. The Joseph Center Foundation will also provide scholarships for business training for those people who come from backgrounds who lack the means to actually go through our program. We'll provide scholarships for them. And lastly, we're going to produce 100,000 entrepreneurs that their businesses are going to have a minimum of $1 million in revenue, and we're going to do it all within 5 years. 100,000 millionaires. I'm saying this because we'll take that kind of revenue to help us destroy poverty. I'm telling you, a lot of times we talk about destroying poverty, but we don't mention the kind of money that is needed to do it. You're gonna help me generate what is needed so that we can eradicate poverty and wipe it off the map. Praise God. Well, if you'd like to learn more about the Joseph Center Foundation, I want you to visit us at josephcenterfoundation.org. Again, josephcenterfoundation.org. I know it's a big vision, but God's going to have you with a big business. Thank you in advance for your support. God bless you.
Well, you guys just heard that. The Word of God says God does nothing until He reveals it to His servants and prophets. 100,000 entrepreneurs within the next 5 years. How many entrepreneurs are in that group? To see every hand go up. Amen. Well, now I'd like to introduce a very special guest, Brianna Harrelson. And she will perform an interpretive dance with her student, Kennedy Edwards. Now, if you're wondering what an interpretive dance is, it depicts a story or a definite emotion rather than just following an abstract pattern. Now, Brianna herself is also a 2018 Joseph Business Scholar and a graduate of JBS, as well as founder of Breeze Place, a dance studio located in Merrillville, Indiana. She provides classes for all ages. I mean, there's no age limit to dancing, amen? Okay, I just want to mention that. She provides classes for all ages, stages, and abilities, while at the same time focusing on age-appropriate choreography, music, and costuming. Their motto is, we just don't teach dance, we teach life. Let's welcome Bree.
Yeah. You're a man of your word.
Wasn't that wonderful? Well, at this point, I'd like to again welcome both of our deans to the stage, Dean Dave Ramshure and Dr. Irene Abrams.
Thank you. Let's give Bree and Kennedy another hand clap. What we'd like to do at this point is just give a couple highlights of the school year that we experienced with the current cohort of students who are graduating today. And to first start off with the campus cohort of students, we gathered every Saturday to learn and interact and learn different aspects about business every week. And one of the highlights of the school year occurred when we went on one of our two field trips virtually. We took these students to hear from business owners on these field trips, and we had the opportunity to visit with JBS alumni Marlene Barrett. You may recognize Marlene as the character Maggie Lockwood on NBC's Chicago Med. We actually have a picture we'd like to show of Marlene if we could bring that up. There she is. Marlene shared with the students her journey in the entertainment industry and how she applied biblical principles in her roles as an actress, producer, writer, director, and business owner. Marlene reinforced the concepts the students were learning in the classes and how she had been blessed with achievements such as producing an Oscar-nominated film that has earned more than 40 awards in the film industry. So it was a blessed time with her. Amen. Another highlight of the school year is that every student has made significant progress in moving forward on their and manifesting their business vision. And I'll just give you a few examples of some of the students. First is Sheila Neals from Indiana. Amen. We affectionately refer to Sheila as the cake lady. And Sheila attended culinary school some time ago, but did not receive any business training. And as a result, her bakery business had been home-based for a long time. But while she was at JBS, she was able to legally form her business as an LLC, get her business up on social media, and get her products out into the marketplace. Amen. And she is well positioned now to get a physical location for opening her bakery. Amen. We also have Donna Winfrey. And Donna is the president of her real estate and development company located in Houston, Texas. We got a few folks up from Houston, Texas area today, so we hope they're doing all right with the weather, so they're gonna be all right. But Donna's company focuses on commercial real estate market. And as you know, that was hard hit during the pandemic area. And Donna came to the class believing God would restore and exceed her business to pre-COVID levels. And during the program, a property owner who had previously told Donna no, now agreed to list his $3.3 million property with her during the school year. In addition to that, this month, a former client came back and agreed to purchase two properties up to $500,000. So Donna's doing on her way. And finally, we have Prince Adeteo Jeolia. And he's also from Houston. Teo was originally from Nigeria, and he had developed a plan to be an internet service provider where that internet, reliable internet service is really needed in Nigeria. And Teo has shared that he has received clarity for his vision. And as a result, during the program, he's had accelerated movement toward that vision. And he has now secured and furnished office space in Nigeria and is in the process of hiring technical and engineering staff as well. And he's also on the brink, amen, give him a hand clap. And he's on the brink of getting a very significant license to propel his business to a new level. Amen. Now, Dr. Irene's going to share some highlights as well on the Executive Accelerator Program.
Amen. Thank you, Dean Dave. I'm actually going to share a highlight. I'm going to combine the highlights with the online program and the Executive Accelerator Program. I am so proud of both classes. This year, we really wanted to focus on community and collaboration. And as you know, with this global pandemic, we had to do everything virtually. And we have amazing platforms called D2L, Desire to Learn, as well as Zoom. And so what we did was our Executive Accelerator program, they met 3 times a week. And our online program, they met once a week. This year, our global classroom ranged from students from different parts of the world with one goal in mind. And that was to learn how to do business God's way. These students understood the power of community and camaraderie. They encouraged each other. They prayed for each other's businesses. They held each other accomplished, and they held each other accountable. And as the dean, I was inspired each and every day to lead this group of world changers who are dedicated, consistent, and persistent. I'm also proud to say that whether it was a 9-month program or the 6-week Executive Accelerator program, students joined from all walks of life to successfully complete the program. As a result, we have an over 92% completion rate that is higher than the national average. These students, while in school, use innovation to scale their businesses, and today they are ready to dominate the marketplace. Congratulations, online and Executive Accelerator students. I would now like to call for 3 student testimonies. I would like to call Dr. Lawrence Salone to share his experience of the Executive Accelerator program. I would like to call Crystal Love, a student from the campus program, to share her experience. And we have a video of our online student, Della Stein.
Good morning. My name is Dr. Lawrence Salone, and I'm the founder of Post Trauma Institute, and we are a mental health care system impacting both clinical and corporate environments. Today, I'd like to share what JBS has meant to my business, my family, and my faith. But first, let's pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, we come today to celebrate the kingdom businesses that have been sown through Joseph Business School. Father, thank you for Dr. Winston and his vision to equip entrepreneurs with access to a higher level. May you give him fresh new vision, health, and supernatural wisdom. May he harvest that billion flow from the very seeds he's planting through JBS. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. Matthew 6 speaks of a time when Jesus and his disciples were in a boat and things got hairy. Jesus was in the bottom of the boat asleep. That's reflective of what a lot of business owners do. We keep Jesus at the bottom of the boat until we get in trouble. When things are all right, God, I got this, you know, I'm okay. But let's let that storm hit. God, where you at? You know, that was my existence for 10 years, and I got tired of living like that. Isaiah 48:17's emphasis mine says he'll teach you what you need to know and how to profit. At the Faith Conference last year, I was blessed to sit next to Miss Melissa, and she spoke so highly about JBS that I had to join. Okay, I decided to take the next 6 weeks and just trust God. I was all in. What stood out at the program early on was that we incorporated prayer, the word, into just normal business experiences. I'd be in my prayer closet, and God would tell me things. And I decided to act on each and every one of them. The growth wheel pushed us. It challenged us to go beyond your comfort zone. The power of meditation was a roadmap. Hebrews 6:14 says, surely in blessing I will bless you, and in multiplying I will multiply you. God is in the multiplication business. The Holy Spirit showed me an opportunity that's unique to PTI, that when fully operational this year is 354% increase on what we did last year. I'll close with this. If you're on the fence about whether or not God's ways work, guys, I'm here to tell you that they do. On Friday, January 7th, this year, we were notified that our proposal to take over psychiatric services for a hospital system in Arizona was approved. This means we're national now. To the JBS leadership, Dr. Winston, staff, may God continue to bless this program. May you get those 1,000 businesses to fund every business that God is sending your way. Thank you.
Good morning. I'm Crystal Love, JBS Spring Class of 21-22, and the founder and CEO of the Love Charitable Foundation, based in New York City. Today I will be sharing the journey of our STEM-based biological sciences program, SEED, which stands for Science, Exploration, Education, and Discovery. SEED brings the lab experience directly to the schools and communities of students grades 6 through 12. We're giving them hands-on experience with cutting-edge concepts used in both academic and industry labs. When I first came to JBS, I had no idea that this was the direction that God would lead me. I had a different business, but I was really struggling for direction. One of the first of our assignments was to write a confession for our business and the outcome that we desired. As I continued to say my confession, pray, and attend chapel, one day the Lord revealed to me an idea that was so far away from what I was doing, and he had me pivot completely into a different direction. And so the SEED program was born. Since then, like it says in Isaiah 48:17, I am the Lord thy God, which teacheth thee to profit. I have had supernatural progress in manifesting the business vision. As I applied the practical steps from class to develop the business concept, the Lord provided me with many divine connections. Although my plan was to run a one-week pilot program, God had other plans. Fast forward. We are now entering the fourth month of a full-fledged 8-month program and at a middle school in the South Bronx. Now that's how God does a pilot program. Anyway, in the interest of time, I'll fast forward a bit and cut to the chase. SEED has attracted wide-scale interest from other schools within the district based on the reception from the community. We are in contract talks for 2 summer camps. We have already negotiated a contract with a major housing development. We are in serious discussions with one of the largest school districts in the country. The impact on these children has gotten both local and national attention. We have been able to move forward without toil and are in the season of gathering. All of this has happened in a few months since I started with JBS. I don't even have the words to do it justice about how great God has been. And how great and supportive our JBS family has been. We have something really, really special in JBS, and the faculty and leadership are truly anointed. We have rich, nurturing environment that allows us to dare to dream. So in closing, I would like to take the next minutes to show a video of what's been going on with our SEED program since October. Kindly show the video.
The SEED program, which stands for Science, Exploration, Education, and Discovery, provides STEM-based workshops focused on the biological sciences for students grades 6 through 12. We offer students hands-on experience with scientific applications that are used in both academic and industry laboratories.
The essence of what SEED is all about is really not only building community, but building our future.
You're going to use these chromosomes to mimic what you're seeing there. And at each stage, once you've got it, take a picture, move on. Eventually, you're going to send all the pictures to me, and I'm going to put it on a graph. show how you go and that's COVID.
We are shaping our future innovators one mind at a time.
Drop the mic.
We have the video. There we
Hello,
go.
My name is Della Stein, and I am an attorney. I practice in my own law firm, the Law Office of Della Stein. I practice in California, though I'm also licensed in Illinois. I practice in the area of trademark law, where I provide trademark help businesses provide the trademark protections for their business and product names and design logos. I also practice in the area of business law, where I focus on commercial contracts, specifically technology contracts, as I practice in Silicon Valley. Before coming to the Joseph Business School, I would say my biggest challenge was I wasn't making any money. I wasn't making enough money to cover my expenses, and it put a big strain on our personal finances, my family's personal finances. I also was practicing in so many different areas, trying this and trying that and doing this and doing that, and I just wasn't winning. And so that was sort of a big challenge. And I also didn't know what it took to run a business. And I think, you know, just coming to that realization that, you know, I'm not winning, something is missing. You know, after seeing the advertisement, you know, I still tune into Living Word Christian Center's YouTube videos and what have you. And so seeing the video for the Joseph Business School, and then the Lord just dropped in my heart that now is the time to jump into that. And so I applied and got accepted into the program. And I have learned so much. I've grown so much as a professional, learning and understanding the parts of a business, the importance of sales and marketing, the importance of knowing who my customer is, to identify them as people, not just sort of a nebulous idea of who I can serve, and to learn how to do research to identify who those people are. And if there are enough people out there who are interested in the services that I provide to support my business. So those are things that I have learned. Also, my business has grown during the course of the program after a lot of prayer. And I know that the staff and the faculty and everyone's praying for us. And so for me personally, the Lord just confirmed in my heart the area that I'm supposed to focus on, which is the commercial contracts. And since that time, He has given me favor. He's opened up doors. I have clients that I just shake my head when I think about who I'm working with and the clientele that I have and the things that I'm doing. It's the favor of God. And so not only that, but I have also started to make a profit. I'm growing. Not only with the number of clients that I have, but also financially. And in fact, I'm on track for 200% growth, you know, from last year to this year, you know, which is incredible. And I'm so thankful to the Lord for that. And so I just want to say thank you to Dr. Bill Winston for this program, being obedient to the Lord and just bringing it to bear for thanking Dr. Dolores Thomas, Dr. Irene Abrams, my advisor, Attorney Thomas Alexander, just all the faculty, all the staff, everyone who pours into the program, and even my fellow students, cohorts. We haven't had a chance, even the online program, we had a chance to do some work together and just getting to know some of the people in my cohort and learning from them. It's just been incredible. I look forward to being able to use all the lessons that I've learned as my business continues to grow, as I'm able to use everything that I've learned in not only the business, my business, but also as I am advising and working with other businesses that I get to serve. So thank you, thank you, thank you.
Amen. Thank you for those testimonies. Dr. Winston, if you could join us on the stage. As a sign of your accomplishment, we would like to award this year's Joseph Business School graduates their certificate of completion. Will the campus cohort please stand? Please stand. Janine Beasley. Sonia Blakey. Danielle Collins. Alicia Coney. Cynthia Connor. Kashonda Crosby. Marisol Cruz. Xiomara Flores. Ramona Green. Nicole Harris. Prince Areteo Jayola. Crystal Love. Felicia Lida. Mark Mayfield. Kelia McKinney. Sheila Niels. Doris Page. Bozina Root. Helen Slaughter. Keisha Smith.
Calpurnia Smith Canty. Donna Winfrey. Yolanda Wright. And we have campus students who are not able to make it today, and we'd like to show their pictures. Bridget Cooper. Ina Graham. Belinda Hardin. Carolyn Hartshore. Keisha McGee. Amen. Lastly, each year we acknowledge the student with the top academic standing for the school year as the Joseph Scholar. This year's winner for the campus program is Nicole Harris. Nicole, would you please come forward? Nicole receives a plaque for her award today and a check for $1,000 to help fund her business. Dr. Irene. Congratulations. You may be seated.
I would now like to ask the online spring cohort of 2022 to stand, please. As a sign of your accomplishment, I would like to call each of your names. Crystal Alexander. Jatarius Boyd. Eric Cooley. Susie Henderson. Crystal Johnson. Pamela Jones. Shamika Lindsay. Sharon Marshall. Samantha Okikidai. Talicia Parker. Charletta Reed.
I'm going to give her a lead one.
Wilfred Reed.
Dr. Veronica.
Jacqueline Williams. There were several of our students that weren't able to come in person, so we would like to read their names. Vivian Baker. Gladys Barnes. Christopher Bender. Atia Black. Claudio Cognac. Lizette Clark. Prescott Cox.
Laurent D. Winter. Genevieve Hammond. Gladys Jones. Joy Mitchell. Evelyn Noble. Dr. Lakeisha Payton. Yolanda Rogers. David Shirley. Della Stein. Boza Toggs. And Jerlana Walker. Congratulations. We would now like to call up our online Joseph Scholar, Crystal Alexander. Congratulations. Congratulations, class. You may now be seated. Dr. William and Veronica Winston, it is with great honor I introduce to you the first time, the first online JBS Executive Acceler program. This is the fall class of 2021. This class represents students from six states and one student from Canada. Our students are emerging leaders who have committed their lives to answering that God call that God has placed on their lives to change the world as well as the business industry. We would like to also recognize the participation of a 14-year-old child prodigy who is currently enrolled in Southern University and A&M College studying physics and mechanical engineering, who had the opportunity to audit the program. At the end of 6 weeks, more than half of the students received contracts and funding valued at over $10 million. As a sign of their accomplishment, I would now like to read the names of the students that are awarded the JBS Executive Accelerator Program Certificate of Completion. Class, would you please stand? Wanda Boone. Kimberly Burt Hendricks. Jessica Ford. Elijah J.D. Priestley. Dr. Lawrence Salone. Wincy Terry Bryant. We have several students that weren't able to come. We'd like to recognize them. Talithia Beverly. And Pastor David Olabog. Congratulations to all of our Joseph Business School graduates and Executive Accelerator Program graduates. You are destined to change the world. Congratulations. You may now have your seat. In the spirit of collaboration and the spirit of community, the online, campus, and Executive Accelerator Program, all cohorts came together for a special project and special presentation for you, Dr. Winston. At this time, I would like to call forth for the special presentation.
Dr. Winston, it is an honor to stand before you and represent our class, the spring cohort for 2022. It is a true blessing to represent the prayers that you have prayed. All of us who are here today are birthed in your prayers. We were birthed in your prayers, and we just wanted to say with our plaque and a gift to your grocery store, Living Fresh Market, and show how much we love you with a check for $5,200. And hallelujah. So we give God praise to be able to present you with that, sir, as well as a plaque that just lets you know that you're the reason we're here. You're the reason that we're celebrating today, and we don't take that lightly. We appreciate it, and we love you, and we thank God for you.
Thank you very much, class. And I think this is the first time in 20 years anybody ever given me some hard, cold cash. This is amazing. You will succeed. Amen. Give them a hand. Thank you.
Am I?
Okay.
We just want to say, all classes.
Yes.
Thank you so much. We watch your broadcast on Wednesdays and Sundays, and you speak highly of the store, the food restaurant.
Amen.
And grocery store, and we just wanted to come together as a collaboration in order to present this.
Well, thank you very much. Give them a hand. Thank you so much for this wonderful gift. Amen. Thank you.
Give the graduates another hand clap, please.
Thank you, sir.
I'd like to bring up Dr. Veronica to pray for the graduates, if you could, please.
What an honor to be called into the realm of business. You have slain your Goliaths. Goliaths you never knew were out there. And guess what? This is not the last time. But you're equipped. And know that we, the intercessors, are praying for you and are praying for your success. When Jesus looked for those dozen that would continue his message, his freeing, empowering message of the kingdom of God, he didn't look for rabbis. He didn't look for Pharisees, Sadducees, or scribes. He looked for businessmen, fishermen, tax collectors. He looked for those who knew what it meant to be fruitful. Because his kingdom would not be sustained until the end of time unless his laborers knew the value of producing and multiplying themselves. And so let us pray that you will continue in those footsteps. Father in heaven, we bless those that have begun to walk with you and who will continue to walk with you to continue your legacy in the realm of business. Father, you called Abraham. You called him to go into a land that he did not know. And for these, you have called them unto a place which eye has not seen and ear has not heard, but they said yes to you because you promised to bless them, to make of them a great nation, to multiply them to the uttermost parts of the earth. And so, Father, we bless them as you blessed Abraham. And because they are Christ's, they are Abraham's seed and heirs according to that same promise. Your promise is that if they would just hearken to you and they have learned how to hear from you in the realm of business. And if they obey what you tell them to do, as they seek you for guidance and instruction, yes, they know natural, but you are the God. You said, I will bless you. I will increase you. I will multiply you. So they know that you are the God that teaches them to profit and leads them in the way they should go. They know that you are the God who gives them power to get wealth. And so for these dynamic men and women who knows where their help comes from, we bless them to grow and to multiply into that realm of the billionaire status as was prophesied through the woman of God. It will take walking on water, walking where it does not look like this can sustain them, but your word sustains them. Your prophetic direction sustains them. And so, Father in heaven, we thank you and we honor you that they will honor you. They will honor you and they will let all that come across them know that it was not me. It was the Lord, my God, that gave me power to get wealth. Because there is good news to set the captives free from poverty and lack and financial oppression. And you have said yes to God's call. And so, Father in heaven, we thank you. We decree and we prophesy that billion flow. And we thank you, Lord God, that it is your hand that is upon them, that you will be an enemy to all of their enemies and an adversary to their adversaries, that you will increase them more and more because of the blessing which rests upon them. And so, Father in heaven, we release them to go. Go to the north, go to the east, go to the west, go to the south, and multiply and increase and be a blessing and set the captives free and prosper families and prosper communities and prosper cities, prosper races of people and ethnicities, prosper those who have been beaten down and those who have been cast aside and those whom the world has given up on, but the Lord God has seen them and has heard their cry, and the Lord has sent you as he sent Moses to deliver them from financial bondage and to bring them into the land of abundance. Bless, oh God, and increase as you have promised in the name of Jesus. We give you all the praise and all the honor and all the glory, and God's wealthy entrepreneur said yes and amen. So be it. Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise God. Now we all want you to run with that prayer, amen? Yeah. Well, now to present one more selection is our Living Word Christian Center praise team, after which the next voice you will hear will be the founder of JBS and our own beloved pastor, Dr. William Winston. Praise team, you may proceed.
One. How many know that the work of the Lord is already finished? Amen. Everything that he has promised you, everything that he has told you he's going to do for your business, everything that he is going to do, it's already done in your life. Amen.
Everything that I'll ever need was accomplished on Calvary.
right. 2, 3, 4. All right. Well, give all our graduates a hand clap. Praise God. And now, we also want to recognize all the people who really are involved in getting them the knowledge that they should have so that, yeah, let's stand and give all those who taught, who administrated, who give all the spouses a hand clap, and, you know, everybody's had something to do with it. Well, thank you very much. Well, we thank God for it. Like Dr. Thomas said, we started with very humble beginnings. The Bible says in Job chapter 8, verse 7, though thy beginning be small, your latter end shall greatly increase. And so that's what we want to experience. We want to experience that great increase. We don't want to stay small. Say amen to that. So I just looked at the graduates coming up here and hearing some of the testimonies. I tell you, it does me good. Every time I come in for a JBS graduation, I could tell my wife gets overwhelmed by it. I mean, I do too. Sometimes I'm not very emotional, but I'm believing and I'm turned on. Praise God. So give yourself one more hand clap, please. Okay, just a few minutes. I just want to speak to you about dreaming impossible dreams. Dreaming impossible dreams. when I was a little kid, I had a dream over and over again. And Father, we thank you for this message. So we thank you and bless it now in Jesus' name. Amen. But over and over again, I was brought up in Tuskegee, Alabama, where I think was a place full of visionaries. And so I had a dream that when I would go to sleep, I'd get thirsty. I'd wake up and I'd go through the living room and go towards the kitchen to get some water. And lo and behold, in the living room, my dad would have, he was friends with the local funeral home director. And they had more caskets than they had accommodations for. And so my dad apparently agreed to have them to put some of the caskets in our living room. And now I'm a little boy having this dream. And so, my goodness, I'd wake up and go to the living room and all these caskets would be there. So then I would get the water and quench my thirst. And then I'd come back through the living room and all the caskets, the tops would fly open and every dead person would sit up. Now, can you imagine having that dream as a little boy? So I used to be kind of terrified. So when I got to ORU, I asked this guy Otis, who was interprets dreams. I said, Otis, what is this dream that I had? And he said, even as a little boy, God showed you that you're going to be bringing people from death to life and so forth. Amen. And I think a part of that is really for us understanding where we came from. The Bible says that you didn't choose me, I chose you. And even over in Jeremiah chapter 1:15, he said, before you were formed in your mother's womb, I knew you. So right there, that speaks right there about something that the Bible talks about, a life in the womb. And so this is interesting. Before you came into the earth, he knew you. That's powerful. And so I'm saying that your being born in this earth was deliberate. And you were not a mistake, you were not an accident, but God had a plan. And then it says,
chosen, that you didn't choose me, he said over in John 15 and verse 16, but I chose you and ordained you that you're going to be going forth and bearing much fruit. So God saw you not only birthed, but he saw you chosen. And the Bible talks about in Romans chapter 8 and verse 15, I think it is. He says that the gifts and the callings of God are without repentance. Meaning that whatever he gifted you to do, he won't take it back. So you were known before you got into your mother's womb. You were chosen and you were gifted. So you're all prepared for what God has for you to do. Now, the thing that Joseph Business School does is help to build capacity. Help to build capacity. Jabez over in 1 Chronicles chapter 4, verse 9, he said, that thou would bless me indeed and enlarge my territory, that your hand be with me and you keep me from evil. Jabez recognized that his problem wasn't how he was named. The problem was how he thought. And he had to fix his thinking. And that's what we do in Joseph Business School, is to fix your thinking. Now, the Bible says about things that we look at, that we look not at the things that are what? Seen, but the things that are not seen. The things that are seen are temporal, subject to change. But the things that are not seen are eternal. So there's an eternal plan. And God says, I know the plan that I have for you, Jeremiah 29 and 11. It's a plan for good and not for evil in the Amplified translation, please. And so I'm just saying that God chose you, knew you before your womb, gifted you, so you're already gifted. And he has a plan for you. And it's a plan for good to give you prosperity. That's what it says in one of the translations. So my point to you is that you're loaded. Say, I'm loaded. You are loaded. And you know, one of the biggest things I find is that we have to stir up the gift. You have to stir up the gift. If people come in, they've been so beat down until they think they don't have that value that God has given them in the beginning. And so as a result of that, you'll see that manifested and they end up really either thinking small, not doing much, so forth and so on. But the Bible says in Genesis chapter 1, verse 28, and God blessed them. That means to empower to prosper. He empowered you for success. He blessed them and he said unto them, be fruitful and multiply and replenish this earth and subdue it. So I've got to first be fruitful. Be fruitful means that I've got to bring something forth. As obviously to bring something forth, I'm going to have to get it from God. If I've got an idea, if I'm going to bring an idea forth, I'm going to have to get God's idea. I think the tendency is sometimes we get some human idea. And because we've been in an environment that's reasonable. But God is calling you to do the impossible. He's going to give you a dream so big, amen, that if you're not vigilant, you'll kind of cast it aside. You'll think, you know, that's for somebody else. But you're in the Joseph Business School. And in that school, you're taught to dream big. You're taught to dream the impossible dream. Now, it says write the vision. So as soon as you get it, you better have a pad to write it down. Because those things can be stolen. But here was Joseph, and he had that dream, and he told it in Genesis 37. He told it to his brothers. And when he told it, he wrote it. Because the Bible says in Psalm chapter 45, verse 1, the tongue is the pen of a ready writer. So when you tell it, you write it. And you can write it on the tablet of your heart. Say amen to that. So I'm saying here that, you know, God will give you things, and sometimes he'll take you incrementally to another level and so forth like that. But I've got journals at home that go all the way back, but I have to go back sometime and consult my journals, because those kind of dreams are so big that the enemy likes to steal those and cause you not to fulfill them. But you will fulfill your dream. You are going to have an impossible dream. God's going to give you a plan for that dream. So you got a divine dream. It's a divine seed or a divine idea. And then God gives you a divine strategy. Glory to God. And then God gives you divine connections. And then, you know, I like to look at that place where he gave Joshua divine connections. Joshua said he picked two men to send them into the Canaan land to spy out the land and come back. I guess he had learned something about sending 12. So sometimes you can send too many. And so he sent two, and they went into the promised land. But remember, you always have divine connections. I said, remember, you always have divine connections. God's going to give you some connections that help you fulfill your dream. And in their connection, they happen to go by a house of ill repute. They call it a home of prostitution. And so he connected them with that. Now, I know that's kind of weird. Is God sending them in there? God will use connections. Now, I'm not saying he's used that connection for you, but he'll use connections that you don't expect to connect you with what it takes to fulfill your dream. And so what happened was, of course, here is Joseph. He had a dream. And look what God did. God had his brothers to actually transport him. Now, what he said is, when he got down, when they finally joined him in Genesis chapter 45, he said, listen, he said, now, you think you sent me down here, but you didn't. God sent me here. Say amen to that. And he sent me here to preserve life for you. And so it's interesting what God will use, his connections and so forth. When I was, God spoke to me about buying the shopping mall. Now, he didn't show it to me ahead of time. He didn't show it to me when I first got here with $200. He showed it to me when I had built capacity. And so now I see the shopping mall, and then God says, okay, buy that shopping mall. Well, that's all he gave me was a seed. And then he began to give me the things that I needed. He gave me the resources, gave me the bank to go to, all the things that are strategies and plans to make that dream come to pass. And so here it is right here. Now, God is not done. I said, God is not done. Don't think where you are now is where you're going to be. And so what happens sometimes, people stop dreaming. Don't stop dreaming. God wants you to be a perpetual dreamer. He said, even in Psalm 92 and verse 14, even you'll bring forth fruit at old age. At old age. And a representative of that, of course, is the wife of Zacharias, who was Elizabeth. And he told Mary, your cousin Elizabeth at her old age, the angel said, is now pregnant, 6 months pregnant with child. So in that, I'm just seeing here that God generates this vision for you. And in John chapter 15, he told Abraham, come and look at the stars. How many can you see? They tell me you can't see but 5,000 stars at night with a natural eye. That's as much as you could see. But God told Abraham, as far as you can see, that will I give you. T.L. Osborne says it like this. He says, you decide how big you want to be. You decide how far up you want to go. You decide how influential you want to be. You decide how wealthy you want to be. You see what I'm saying? Because I used to say the sky is the limit, but that's not the limit for you. You can go beyond that limit. Say amen. That's for the world. Now, so I look at all these people that have received vision, big visions, and I look at course of Joseph and look at Abraham, but also I look at Ruth. I think Ruth saw something. She told her mother, even though her sister went back to the Moabites, she said, listen, she said, you know, where you go, I'm going to go. He said, and your God shall be my God. Now, for her to say that and not go back to those Moabites, she saw something. While we look not at the things that are seen, but the things that are not seen. Now, I'm saying to you, if God told you to be fruitful, God is obligated to give you a dream. How can you be fruitful without a seed? So he just obligated himself. So you need, from now on, you need to go on your nightstand there by the bed or whatever. You need to put a little pad there, because God may show you something and wake you up at night, and you need to jot it down real quick. So I see Ruth, I see David. David, of course, he said, listen, this day the Lord's going to deliver you into my hand. Not only that, I'm going to cut your head off, but Goliath, I'm also going to feed your whole army to the buzzards of the air. That's big talk. That's because he was a big dreamer. Say amen to that. And I also saw the Apostle Paul, Acts 26, how Paul talked about the heavenly vision that God had given him. He showed him a picture of Paul being instrumental in saving the whole world. But this, you know, is a tendency that we have to think that these kinds of things Jesus didn't have to go through. And here's what I have to be reminded of all the time. Jesus had to come to the earth as a man. He was fully God and fully man, but he had to go through the same kind of things that the first man would have to be limited by or go through for him to be valid, for him to really walk out the walk that God had planned for him to walk, and for him to be legal in doing the things that he did. One time, even the demons told him, you can't touch us. We know who you are. You are God. And Jesus said, come out of him, you unclean spirit. And they came out. Why could he do that? Because he was acting as a man. So I just saw, if that be the case, over in John's Gospel, chapter 10, verse 34, Jesus said, I'm going to suffer. I'm going to die. And in 3 days, I'm going to rise back up again. Look at that dream. Jesus had a dream of saving the whole world. Now, I'm telling you this because you're not in an ordinary program. You have just come through Joseph Business School. Say amen to that. God has blessed you. That means that the blessing that is on you is designed to make you the wealthiest person wherever you are sent. I'll try that one more time. The blessing that is on you is designed to make you the wealthiest person wherever you are sent. Here was Abraham. He said over in Abraham in Genesis 24 and verse 35 that the Lord has blessed my master greatly. He has flocks and herds and men servants, maid servants, and so forth. If you look at Isaac's life, Isaac chapter 26 and verse 12, he talks about Isaac got so rich in verse 14 or 16. They asked Isaac because they envied him and he had everything. They said, leave this country. You are too mighty for us. Now notice that same blessing was also on Jacob, and Jacob worked with Laban and took everything that Laban had. I'm just saying that same blessing is on you. But here was Jacob that worked for Laban for over 20 years and did not capitalize on the blessing that was on his life. And I'm saying you're going to be different. From today going forward, that blessing on your life is going to start manifesting. It's going to start manifesting new ideas. It's going to start manifesting innovation. Come on, it's going to start manifesting all these things that the blessing is designed to do, to make you the head and not the tail, to make you the lender and not the borrower. You're going to bring in such revenue until Jess no longer going to have to be concerned about the foundation program. You're going to finance it. One of you can finance it yourself. So I was telling Dr. Thomas, I said, listen, you know, what would it be like if we now started a program and people who didn't have the money would be scholarshiped? But the people who graduated from the previous class will pay for their education. Let's try that again. The people who graduated from the previous class will pay for their education. Now, you know, if you pay it, you're sowing a seed. Say amen to that. You know it's good ground because you have proof of it. And when you sow that seed, my God shall supply. Oh. Look at the shopping mall. I sowed to get it. Look at the ministry airplane. Sowed to get it. Look at the other things that we've done. We've sown to get it. My point to you is, sowing a seed is God's way to expand your life. So, here is Joseph. Now, what did he do? He told his father, his brothers, in terms of his dream, and his father rebuked him and said, what is this dream that you've dreamed? And Joseph then was silenced really by his brothers or by those who are his close family. They plotted against him, schemed against him, sold him. But notice Joseph never let the bitterness get in his heart. But what did he dream? He was taken down to Egypt. Why? Because that was the environment he needed to bring forth an economy that God had loaded in him before the foundation of the world. And I'm saying the same thing about you. Sometimes you have to monitor your environment. Sometimes you have to check to see, is there any peace in your environment? Lord have mercy. God's plan was to have Israel to be the distributor of all the provisions. But what happened was, because his father wouldn't accept his revelation, he had to take it to a place they could accept it. Now, I'm saying something here now. This is very important. There are two pieces to a revelation. Usually, the one who holds the revelation and the one who needs the revelation. And you got to understand that this kings and priests that I've written about, I've talked about and taught about, that whole thing is a lot of times driven by supply and demand. That you've got to put a demand on that man or woman of God so that they can bring forth that revelation. I really believe that Cindy Jacobs had to come to this church, that there was a demand put on her that she could bring forth a statement that some of you seek to be millionaires, but God said, can't I make you billionaires? And I think that kind of statement is brought out when the demand is placed on the prophet to make that kind of statement. I'm saying from now on, don't just come to church. Come to get a demand, place a demand on this thing. And when Pharaoh placed a demand on Joseph, he got a revelatory answer. He got a plan of how to go through the famine without being touched and so forth and so on. So I'm saying to you that God has done some great things to you right now. He's put something in you. He's opened up your capacity. He has now put a hunger in you. And not only that, a kingdom hunger. And that means that you, watch this, even can make the kind of revenues that are needed so that you could open up school choice. Yeah. See, a lot of people in the cities can't go to the schools that they'd like to because they just don't have the moolah. But suppose you come along and break off about $1 billion and make it so a lot of those students will have school choice. Now they won't have to be subject to certain things. So my point to you is the kingdom financing is actually using the resources that God's going to have you to produce for the expansion of God's kingdom. And that's why you've been called. I want to say congratulations to you, because this is going to be one of the most powerful classes. Watch this, because you're going to reach back and finance somebody that the other classes didn't even do. This, and watch this. I'm praying for Amos 9:13 that you're going to multiply so fast, it's going to make your head swim. I said, as a matter of fact, I'm decreeing it right now. You're going to accelerate in your business so fast, it's going to make your head swim. Say amen to that. I decree it right now. Peter got in a boat, but Jesus picked that boat. And Peter was his choice. And he sat down in that boat and drew on that anointing. And the next thing you know, Jesus said, launch out into the deep and let down your nets for the drought. The same day he caught so many fish, it made his head swim. Yeah. And I'm saying, we got modern day fishermen right here. Watch this. He changed the whole coastline of Capernaum with the catch that he made that day. So God's going to use you to do great things. You're going to be a powerful financial source for the kingdom of God. You're going to be a money magnet. Oh, have mercy. That's just coming to me. See, now I feel myself getting over in the flow now. Now, how do I know that? Because I think it's in Luke chapter 21 and verse 8. I think it is. Lord, have mercy. Where am I, Lord? Tell me what that is. 21. No, it could be, Lord have mercy. He said, I will give you a mouth and wisdom that your adversaries will not be able to gainsay or resist. Now, what does that mean? That means when you present your plan before your equity investors, they cannot resist. They cannot resist. Are you following what I'm saying? I'm saying this is all coming on you today. I said it's coming on you today, starting right now. Lift your hands up to the Lord. The Lord bless you and keep you. That means he's going to protect you. The Lord give you favor. God. You keep your hands right there, because I'm led to do this. Glory to God. Hallelujah. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. That means that doors are going to open for you on a whole nother level. It means God's going to be merciful to you. Glory to God. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace, tranquility, and a heart that is continually at peace. Doors shall open for you that have been closed for centuries. Employees shall come to you that are skilled in what they do. You'll never have to struggle in your business and in your your innovation. That things will come to you without struggle or strain in Jesus' name. You'll be at the right place and you'll see things others can't see. From this day, God is saying, I will whisper in your ear. And I will enlarge your capacity for great harvest. Seek me in everything you do, and I will guide you through. Make no mistake, I'm at your side, because I am the one that will provide. Give heed to my word and never take it lightly. For there are things I'm going to do that others have hope for. So this is your day. This is your time of start. This is the first day of the rest of your life. Now receive, saith the Lord. Be not startled when I show up, because I'm here because of my plan to take you up. I will take you to the top of your industry, and I'm going to do it quickly. So rejoice at every step. Every time I receive, every time you receive, give me a shout. Because I'm the one that's going to bring you out. You'll never have to struggle. You'll never have to strain. So from now on, give me praise in his name. Now with that in mind, give God praise and thank him. I'm going to say what I see. 1 year billionaire. I'm going to say what I see. I'm going to say what I see. Because it's going to be inventions that he's going to release to you. Say, I'm open. I'm ready. My capacity has been made great. And I'm ready to receive. Now, in Jesus' name. Amen. Give him a praise. That's it. Glory to God. Give him a praise. That's it. Glory to God. This that you see right here is small compared to what he's showing, going to show you. This is small. Now don't try to do it yourself because it's too big for you. Keep him in the front and on the side too because he's making a way for you in Jesus' name. Amen. Do I have someone to come up to take it from here? Amen. Amen. Amir. Give Minister Amir a hand clap as he conducts this. Boy, I just feel like something's still down in me stirring here. Now, this that I'm about to tell you right now, this is a part of it. You call things. I said call things. You need some money? Call for some. Call things. God said, don't play it so safe. Come on out. He said, I'm out here in the deep. Don't play it safe. Don't try to get and make sure this thing, No, you don't need to do that. I've got it, just start it and I'll help you take it from there. I got that. That just started and I'll help you take it from there. I feel kind of rushed because I got to go somewhere else. But give God praise. Give him a hand clap and receive that. Let's see if I get anything. That's all I got. Come on up. Praise God.
Praise God. Well, how many enjoyed this morning's presentation? Amen. And you know, this wasn't just a graduation event. This was really, and I'll go ahead and say it, and I'm going to come back to this. This was a family celebration. Amen. That's what this was. And speaking of family, we heard so many testimonies come forth. We heard the vision of JBS. It started domestic. It went, it started local. It went domestic. And now it's international. And it's still growing. We heard our students come up. I believe it was Dr. Sloan who had said that now his program is national. And Dr. Sloan, it's just not going to be national. International is next. But God is already moving. We saw a wonderful presentation by one of our alumni. I believe it was Brianna's place, right? And little Kimberly Edward. It was such a joy just to see them present. And then you heard, this was not just a commencement address that the man of God gave us this afternoon. It was a prophetic word. Now I want you to couple that prophetic word with what Cindy Jacobs said. Yes. Amen. And there's a scripture that comes to mind. I believe it's 1 Timothy 18. You can put that up real quick. 1 Timothy 18. You have that up, if you can put it up, please. 1 Timothy 18. Well, I'll go ahead and read it. And it says this. The things I commit unto thee, son Timothy, according to the prophecies which went before concerning thee, that thou by them mightest wage a good warfare. Now look at this in the message. It says, the prophetic word that was directed to you prepared us for this. All those prayers are coming together now. So you will do. You will do this well. Fearless in your struggle, keeping a firm grip on your faith and on yourself. Remember, wherever you go, it is your jurisdiction, and God is going to back you up. Amen? But we do not want to end this family celebration, because notice, I said it's a family celebration because we are all family, right? We have one Father when he's in heaven, and he's the one that's making all of this happen. And I would not want to close this wonderful celebration without inviting someone who may be here this morning and is not in the family. Because what's most important is when it's all said and done, the question is, where are you going to spend eternity? But in order for all of this to happen in the lives of our graduates, the first step they had to take was to come into the kingdom. And in order for the kingdom principles to work, you have to come into the kingdom. So maybe you are here to celebrate the success of a relative that brought you here this morning. Let me let you know, we do not want you to leave without giving you this invitation to come into the kingdom. You all know this, for God so loved the world, he gave his only begotten Son, John 3:16, to whosoever would believe in him would not perish, but have everlasting life. And unless a man is born again, he cannot enter into the kingdom of God. So with every head bowed and every eyes closed, I want you to ask yourself today, God forbid if something were to happen to you, do you know if you would be in heaven or hell? Well, let's change that right now. God said, and you heard the man of God say earlier today, God has plans to prosper you and give you an expected end, but you've got to come into the kingdom. So if you here are not born again and you want to be a part of this family, because God is doing great things, and despite things falling apart in this world, you will know that you're under a solid foundation that will not be shaken, and that's Jesus Christ. And you watching online, perhaps you're hearing this and the Spirit of God is moving on your heart, and you're saying, you know what, I want to be saved. So to our online audience and to those that are here, if you want to be born again, I'm going to ask you to take a bold step of faith and simply just raise your hand. Amen? Just raise your hand. Praise God. How many know the Spirit of God is working? Where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. So I'll give you just another few seconds here. If you know for surety that you want to be a part of this family as well, raise your hand. And if you're watching online and you know you want to be born again, I want you to get ready and repeat this prayer after me. Please repeat this after me. Say, Dear Jesus, Lord Jesus, I come to you now just as I am. You know my life. You know my heart. Forgive me for my sins. I believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of God. He came on this earth. He died for my sins. And on the third day, he arose from the grave and is now seated at the right hand of the Father. Lord Jesus, I ask you, come into my heart. Live your life in me and through me. From this day forward, I belong to you. In Jesus' name, amen. 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 Praise God. Now let me tell you what just happened as you said that prayer. Your name is now being written in the Lamb's Book of Life, and you have now become part of the family of God. We want to welcome you all to the family of our Father. Amen. Now there's a link that you should be seeing on the screen. And for those of you who did raise your hand, we have a hard copy here for you that we will present to you before you leave. It's Pastor's book, Born Again and Spirit Filled. It gives you more insight into what it means that you've made this decision to be born again. And also, we want to bless you with the opportunity to sign up in a free course, 10 weeks, free, online, the Online Foundations course. And that's the next step. You know, what do you do once you're saved? You then become a disciple of God, amen? And you learn the principles of the kingdom, just like our graduates did, so that you too can transform this world. So if you can just send us an email, we'll keep it private. We'll have one of our ministers contact you, and they will give you next steps and instructions to taking the class, and you will be blessed. Amen. Well, I have one more announcement for you, and this just came to me right at the very end. As we conclude after the benediction, how many of you know that a celebration is not a celebration without a feast, right? Right? Am I speaking to the right crowd? Anybody hungry? Praise God. Well, our anointed Harvest Cafe just blessed us this morning. Congratulations to all graduates and their family. If you come to the restaurant, you will receive 50% off your total. Amen? So get ready to feast. Well, again, I want to thank you on behalf of Drs. William and Veronica Winston, our president, Dr. Dolores Thomas, Joseph School of Business, the entire faculty, Living Word Christian Center, for attending this event. So excited to see what the Lord's about to do for the graduates. Brother Dave, did you have something you wanted to share?
For the graduates, we have your certificates and a gift for you back in Sanctuary East, so please head over there afterwards. And if the graduates could stand one last time, please. You may now turn your tassels. Congratulations. Amen.
Amen. Glad you caught that. You can't end a graduation without the switching of the tassels, right? Amen. Well, let's all stand and let's close in prayer. Praise the Lord. Heavenly Father, we thank you for a wonderful family celebration. We thank you, Lord, with the message that went forth. We thank you for the testimonies that we shared so that we can be encouraged. We thank you for the prophetic word that went forth. Yes. And now, Father, as we leave this place, but not your presence, as our graduates have completed the season of training, they are now entering the season of reigning. May you continue to increase them and bless them and give them favor and wisdom. We thank you for the families that are here. We are careful, Lord, as we leave this place, but not your presence. We speak Ephesians 3:20. Now unto him who can do exceedingly and abundantly, far above all you can ask or think, according to the power that worketh within you. And Father, you said, in Isaiah 48:17, thus saith the Lord, thy Redeemer, the Holy One of Israel, I am the Lord thy God, who teacheth thee to prosper and leadeth thee in the way thou should go. Father, have your way. We are so excited to see what you've done and what you're doing and what you're yet about to do. In 2022, the year of the miraculous, we give you praise, honor, and glory. In Jesus' name we pray, and everybody said, amen. Amen. All right, look to your left, look to your right, tell your neighbor Jesus loves you, and so do I, and you are dismissed. Thank you so much, and God bless you.